Well, hey there folks, how you doing? I hope you're doing fantastic, splendid, magnificent. This is the first video of a series of videos where I'll teach you, for you, the beginners, the fundamentals, the basics, or anything you need to know and understand in your game dev journey. In this case, this first video, I'll talk about health systems. I'll teach you a bit of the where it comes, why health system, what's his history, and how to code it and program it inside Unity 3D. So let's begin, shall we? Down in the description you can find the source project so you will be able to follow along with the tutorial. Most of the time, when we talk about health systems in games, we are talking about a character's well-being, and has its origins in fantasy tabletop role-playing game Dungeons & Dragons, published in 1974, where Dave Arneson, the co-creator, created a hit point system to allow characters to survive multiple attacks. This was a simple number that would be modified along with attacks or things your team made. This system has been evolving ever since, and the video games took the system for the same purpose like Dave Arneson. So, if we understand that hit point system, we are talking about a variable that will be the full health of your character, and we can decrease or increase that points depending on what we are doing. Some RPGs use the famous health potions to recover some health, or poison, decreasing the health in the long term. So let's create a health system as good as the good old-fashioned way. So in the ready scene we already have three things set. In this case we are talking about a damage bottom, the health potion bottom, and the player's health slider. The slider will help us to visualize the health value. So inside our scripts folder, let's create a C# script called health system. Let's put it inside our character and let's open the code. Let me clean this up. So the first variable we need to assign is a public float full health. This full health is the limit of our health. In this case, this shall be equal to 100. Let's create another variable that will be another float, in this case be named current health. Let's not assign something in this variable, let's keep it that way. And when we are starting a new game, we shall tell that the current health is the same as the full health. So let's use the awake method to be able to sign that. In this case, this is void awake, and inside it, let's call current health equals full health. And to tell what is our current health, let's use the debug function, debug.log, and let's say the current health equals plus current health. So let's try it out. And as you can see, the current health equals 100. So we shall continue. We can delete this. So the next thing we need to do is to call the health slider to be able to change its value and to visualize our health. In this case, when you want to change a value in your UI, you need to call a namespace just like this. Up here, using UnityEngine.UI. Just like that, you can now call a public slider, and we will call it health slider. Let's save it. Now in the editor, we will put the slider as the reference, just like this. Let's go to the UI. This UI is just a simple canvas, and inside our player, in this case Emilio Doc, we will assign it a health slider, just like this. And now we are changing the slider, but first you need to make sure that your slider, in this case this one, the health slider, the max value equals to the same max health. We could do it manually like this, or We can do it in code. So let's do it with code to make sure that anytime if you change the health value, you will be able to change also the slider in the long term. So let's go to our code, and inside here, let's say that the health slider dot max value equals full health. And also let's do the health slider dot value equals current health. And just like that, if we try it out, let's click the slider, and you can see that the max value is right now set to 1. And as you can see, now the max value equals 100 and the value equals 100 as well. Now let's see what happens if we change our current health. Just right here, let's change it. And as you can see, nothing is happening. Why is that? That mostly because in code we haven't changed anything in terms of updating the slider. So let's go and do it. To be able to change the value, as you can see, it's just using something like this, but inside a new function. In this case is an update method. In this case you will write it as private void update, and inside here let's say that the health slider dot value equals current health. Let's save it up, and as you can see, if we change the current health, you will see that we are doing the updating of the slider as well as the variable. This is one of the most important things in this health system, to make sure that the player can visualize the current health. Now let's add something else. So in this case, we need to make sure that we have a boolean variable. Why is that? That has to do with the fact that we need a boolean to tell if our player is dead or if the game is over. In this case, it's just as simple as writing public bool game over, or in this case we can call it dead. It's up to you. In my case, I will call it game over, and let's put it false as default. And just to make sure, let's add it inside the awake function if something is changed in our editor. And now if we have a boolean called game over, we can make sure if the current health gets down to 0 or less, we are assigning game over as true. And the way you write it is the next. If current health is less or equals 0, then game over equals true. Now also you want to make sure that this is called once. So to make sure that this is called once, we have to add another condition. In this case is adding this to ends, and game over equals false to equals, to make sure that this is an operator. And let's try it out adding a debug dot log game over. Let's save it and try it out. As you can see, everything is working correctly, and if we decrease our health below 0, you get this thing once. Game over equals true. Nice. As you can see, this is very, very easy. And now we shall add something else, because the player is not changing things in the Unity editor. So we need to make sure that the player is getting damage or getting a health potion. When you want to make damage to the player, it's very simple. In our case, we want to use a bottom. So in that case, we can do a function that will do the damage. So let's create it as public void damage. And inside it is as simple as calling current health minus equals and the damage we want to dealt to the player. So we have two options to write it as just everything will damage you just like 10, for example, or is easier if you add another variable that will be the damage. So let's just add as public float damage count. We will assign it just like 10, and inside the public function of damage, let's just change this as damage count. Now we shall tell the bottom to call this function to dealt the damage. So let's go to the damage bottom. Let's see the bottom settings. And inside here, we have an onClick event. This onClick event is just as simple as the name tells it. It's just a function that will make sure that once we click this button, we will do some function. In this case, we want to make a change in our player's health. So let's assign the object as the player, in this case, Emilio Doc, and the function will be inside the health system and will be named damage. Now, as simple as that, if we tried it out, you get damage. You can assign this thing as the attack of your enemies if you have an AI, but in this case we wanted to make it as simple as just a click. If we want to do something to recover our health, it's just as simple as having as reference the damage function. As you can see, we are just using a simple method that will help us to do the damage. In our case, we want to recover our health, so we can do something like this. So public void health potion. And just as simple as calling the current health and plus equals. In this case, we can add a number, a simple number that will be equals for every potion, or tell the editor to use a common variable that can change. In our case, we can use as reference the damage system and create a variable called public float health potion count. In our case, we want to recover 10. And now let's go back to the function health potion and let's add plus equals health potion count. And let's go back to our editor and inside our UI. So let's go to the UI. In this case, this UI is just a simple canvas, and inside it you will find the health potion button. In this case, let's go to his properties of button, and down you will find the onClick event. The onClick event method helps us to see if our player is pressing the button of health potion. Just as simple as going to add to the list, and let's, in this case, call the object we want to change our properties. In this case, we want to change things in our player. So let's go, and Emilio Doc is our player. And inside Emilio Doc, we have a function. In this case, this is the health system. Let's go. And inside it, we have health potion. Just as simple as that. Let's try it out. And as you can see, we can damage our player. And if we try to recover, we may also call the health potion and drink it. And just as simple as that. And in the long term, we can change the values of our potions and damage. For example, we can damage 15 and recover, for example, 30. Just as example, let's try it out. And the game will use it and works just as butter. But there's something else you need to really take. If you are recovering health, there's a a factor we need to understand, and that's something I told you when we created the full health variable. In our case, let's see it as this. If we recover health and just recover and recover, as you can see, the current health variable keeps increasing just because the current health doesn't have a limit. That's why we created the full health variable. So let's go back to code. So let's go to the health potion function and just add something else just after the healing. In this case, we have to add an if statement that will make sure if the current health is higher than the limit. So in this case, you will write it as if current health is higher or equals 100 in this case, but so that's why we have a full health variable. So equals as full health, and inside the if statement, let's add the current health equals full health, and let's try it out. So if we try this, you can see that you cannot surpass the full health limit. This is working properly. And the good thing about this health system is that you can change all these values to work as your game or whatever you want to do. In this case, you can change the full health, for example, 205, and the damage count maybe could be 33, and the health potion could be, 51. And also you have a game over, so if you reach the zero, you can just tell the player, yes, this is a game over. Let's try it out, as you can see. Let's check the slider. And the slider is now set to 205. And let's decrease. Everything is working properly, as you can see. And you can use it in whatever you want. I hope this was useful for you. You can expand this code in really any way you want it. You can increase it, you can decrease it in the long term. Maybe potions. Use it for your games, your RPGs, your action games. I hope this was very, very useful for you, and I hope you did understand it. It's been a long time since I made my first video. It was in March, I think. Yes, it was in March. It was about flying controller inside Unity. And in this case, I wanted to do something for the beginners. And yeah, I hope this was helpful. I hope I'll do more videos more frequently. I hope I can. I'll try to do once or twice, maybe every 2 weeks, every two weeks. Yes, I'll do more videos. I hope so. It depends, mostly because I haven't told you, but I am a student, so I'm suffering inside. I hope you are well today. I hope this was useful. Any question, any comments, any suggestions for new videos, please down in the description. And yeah, thank you for watching. God bless. I love you all. Happy game dev.